outhouse?
We're in the outhouse. It's a little different in here, isn't it?
This is weird. We're in the outhouse, but there's someone else.
We're the only outhouse that we can bring a friend in. Yeah.
Shane, who we have in the outhouse?
The
Adam Condi.
So yes. I don't even know how to introduce. We got Formax, we've got Thorogood. Cool thing is we're Ohio boys.
Yes,
right. That's right.
It's Ohio. 6 degrees of separation from Ohio. No matter, I travel a lot, and no matter where you go, you're gonna run into somebody with a either from Ohio or a connection to Ohio.
Everybody that you run into from Ohio is, they're good people.
Yeah, they are. Yeah. A lot of serial killers too.
What did you say?
We do. Think about it, Dahmer. Charles Manson, I believe, was born in Ohio.
Oh, wow.
Can't spend too much time alone in Ohio.
No. A little gray, can be a little gray, little.
Yeah. Down in Ohio, swag like Ohio. Yeah. Down in Ohio, swag like Ohio.
So Formax Entertainment.
Yes.
What is Formax Entertainment?
Formax Entertainment is my company, named for Max, my son. I'd been off the road as far as being a tour manager. I'd been off the road for a while. I had done a short stint in radio promotions, which I was terrible at. I got fired, and then my boss immediately hired me again, but just she wanted to hire me as just an outsourced person, you know, because she knew my heart was not into radio promotion. So started Formax, and she would hire me to take bands, I wonder, called radio tours, where here's this new artist or band or singer or what have you, and set it up, run them around to radio stations, do the dog and pony show, shake hands, kiss babies. They'd play in the conference room. They'd play in the parking lot. They might play at their, you know, this is our big birthday bash. It was basically to just get them in front of radio, but I didn't have to worry about getting it on air. So that's what I started doing. Right. And then that kind of moved its way into doing some consulting for some music events and some festivals, and hiring all the personnel to work the festivals and you know, techs and so on. And then I knew ultimately I wanted to manage an artist. And by this point I had been out on the road with George Thorogood and the Destroyers for 10 years, and George's manager retired.
What you do is absolutely crazy.
Yeah.
Of all the little steps that you need to like check off and make sure that you have, because one misstep is like
it is. And I remember you guys saying to me when we first started working together, and you were trying to take the workload off of me on just setting up one little filming event, and I remember you being like, God, all the moving parts, and you know, it's a lot.
Yes.
But you being in the industry and kind of like stepped up, you got a lot of the lingo, and I've found more so in your industry, it is really about who you know too, and those relationships, because you just cannot get into this industry by a resume. You have to know like, hey, call Jeff, he's phenomenal, he'll take care of it. You know, I know just the guy for it. And you have this like inner circle that's like its own underground.
It is, and but it's also crazy how I think worldwide it is that way, but it's a very small community, and it's crazy how many people know this person that you already know that you didn't know. You know, I don't know if there was a light bulb moment when I knew I wanted to manage, but I think it was the culmination of starting out as a kid working at a record store, Dingleberries.
Yeah.
And
Dingleberries.
Then I worked at a record store in college called Finders, and backline tech. You
but
know,
but
just,
I want to rewind for a second. We all worked at Dingleberries.
Just about to say, you just dropped the bomb right here, man.
And I want to find the jingle, Dingleberries for you.
Yeah. Dancing Dingleberries. We were all dancing Dingleberries.
All right. Well, cheers, fellas.
Cheers,
Adam. Congratulations on how long? How many years with Formax?
Does this do some math. 2002.
2002.
Yeah. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right. Congratulations, brother.
Cheers.
Yeah. Cheers. And now here's the Dingleberries.
Dingleberries, where the merry record shoppers roam. Where the folks go ape at their jewelry, tapes, records, and pot holders for the home. Dingleberries is our favorite head survival store. With accessories that make it easy to blast your brains to Baltimore. Just take Interstate 75, then drive east on Route 725. Then you're away. They're open every day. As sure as our fur coats are hairy, Dingleberries. D-I-N-G-L-B-X-Q-R-R-Y apostrophe S. Dingleberries for you.
You're still here? It's over.